स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर आयशा सिद्दीका, गवर्नमेंट फर्स्ट एड कॉलेज तुमकुर. दिस इज द वीडियो फॉर बीएससी स्टूडेंट्स हैव टेकन अप केमिस्ट्री इन पेपर 5 ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री ऑफ तुमकुर यूनिवर्सिटी सेशन 19, द लास्ट वन फॉर द कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स अंडर द यूनिट नेचुरल प्रोडक्ट्स. आफ्टर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो द स्टूडेंट शुड बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड द स्ट्रक्चर एंड इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ सम ऑफ द डाइसैक्राइड्स एज वेल एज पॉलीसैक्राइड्स. You should be able to write the Havard structures of sucrose, maltose, cellulose, starch and cellulose. In the previous video, we learnt about the synthesis of the ascending and the descending series in monosaccharides. The methods followed are Killiani-Fischer synthesis and the Holtz method. Before going into the details of the disaccharides, let's understand what is the meaning of glycosidic linkage. Definition: anomeric hydroxyl group of a carbohydrate reacts with hydroxyl group of any other carbohydrate of alcohol or any other molecule to form a product. So please remember, we are talking about the anomeric hydroxyl group of a carbohydrate, that is a monomeric unit, which is reacting with any OH group of another carbohydrate or an alcoholic group or any other molecule. It could be a DNA, nucleic acids or a protein or whatever it could be, and that gives rise to what is known as a glycosidic linkage. A molecule of water is lost wherein one of the OH group and one hydrogen are removed, and this gives rise to a new bond of COC, and it is a covalent bond. Most of them they are referred to as acetals, and the glycosides of glucose are called as glucosides. Let us come and study the Havard structure of disaccharide. Sucrose contains one molecule of glucose and other molecule of fructose, and this is the glycosidic linkage which I was referring to. Here there is a bonding between the first, that is the anomeric carbon, and the OH group and the second carbon, and here it is the beta form and this is the alpha form. Hence the name is alpha-1-2 glycosidic linkage, and the name of this particular sucrose can be alpha glucosyl 1,2 beta fructose or alpha glucopyranosyl 1,2 beta fructofuranose, and we all know this is the source of sucrose for us, the sugar cane. Havard structure for maltose. Maltose contains two glucose units, and the linkage here is alpha 1 and 4, and this is the malt sugar. Malt is obtained from wheat. Malt sugar, it will be liquid, it is not a complete solid. It is a semi-solid or it is slightly liquid in nature. This is malt sugar, and this is the structure of maltose. Lactose is found in milk, which we all consume every day in one or the other form, and this contains one galactose unit and another one is glucose unit. So the anomeric carbon here of galactose is combining with OH group of the glucose. The name or the new pack naming is beta D galactopyranosyl 1,4 D glucose. Cellobiose, it is obtained as a product of partial hydrolysis of cellulose. It contains two glucose units, and the linkage here is beta, not alpha, it is beta 1,4 glycosidic linkage. Let us come to the polysaccharides. In the beginning, we already have studied that polysaccharides are made up of monosaccharide units, and the number will exceed more than 10 here. And these carbohydrates will undergo hydrolysis, hence to give a huge number of monosaccharide units. Therefore, they are the polymers of monosaccharides. Naturally occurring polysaccharides are starch, cellulose and glycogen. These are the starchy foods which we consume every day: bread, cereals, pasta, chestnuts, and even potatoes, rice, starch, beans, etc. Starch, as I just showed you, and those sources are corn, potato, rice, etc. But this is chemically made up of two polymeric units. One is amylose and the other one is amylopectin. Amylose possesses a linear structure with alpha-1,4 glycosidic linkage, whereas amylopectin has got not just one, two, because there is also a cross-linking in between. These are the starchy substances which we consume, powdery starch here. This is the structure of starch. This is amylose having a straight chain, and between two amylose we have cross-linking like this. Between the first and this is the 1,6 linkage and this is the 1,4 linkage. So if you look at it, this is how the cross-linking can be seen in starch. Cellulose, it is the main substance of the walls of plant cell. It helps the plants to remain stiff and upright. This is another polysaccharides. We humans cannot digest this because it contains dietary fiber. Therefore, it is a source of dietary fiber, helps in proper digestion of food. We have different forms of cellulose found in cotton, flax seeds, straw, bamboo, as well as mulberry branches. These are all the native cellulose forms. And this is the dietary fiber which helps to maintain our health. Cellulose resembles starch in most of the ways in its structure. On partial hydrolysis, cellulose is obtained. Complete hydrolysis yields glucose units. These glucose units are joined by the beta-1,4 glycosidic linkage. Only point being, the number of cross-linking is more here compared to starch. So this is about cellulose. And cellulose finds various uses in our life in the form of cloth and various other things. These are the references and questions, structures of starch, cellulose, etc. Have its structures of sucrose, lactose, maltose, etc. And the references. Thank you for watching.